Spokesperson of the Congress, Mahua Mitra is MLA of the Trinamool Congress. She joined me from Kolkata. Atul Anjan is National Secretary of the CPI. Appreciate all of you joining us as we look at this issue. First to you, Abhishek Manu Singhvi, because clearly at the moment, the sense one is getting is that the opposition is badly divided on how to take on Narendra Modi. And today was a glaring example of it. You, for example, are in power in Bihar with the Janata Dal United. You are protesting, but Nitish Kumar Janata Dal United is not. Clearly, in every sense, the opposition appears divided on how far you want to take these protests against Mr. Narendra Modi's demonetization move. Would you concede that on the streets today, you are a divided lot?
Rajdeep, you may be very, very partially and fractionally correct, but largely you are wrong. Let's get it into perspective. Mm-hmm. In the whole of India, there is a huge backlash and a huge upsurge against this conceptually, economically, practically, in terms of pain, and in terms of the very object sought to be achieved.
Now, you have made a sweeping statement that there is anger on the streets. That anger at the moment is not being reflected. All the people today who are out on the streets were mainly political activists, not the Aam Aadmi. And the fact is that the Maharashtra municipal elections held today have shown the BJP winning. So where is this akrosh? Where is this anger that you talk about?
Rajdeep, if your questions are going to be three times the time of my answer, I have no problem. You just extend the time of your program and we'll get enough time. Mm-hmm. At the moment, I have spoken for about 30 seconds and you have spoken for 2 minutes. Let's reverse the ratio, if you don't mind. Mm-hmm. I had just started saying that barring Bihar and barring Odisha, where there is the governments in power have a slightly different approach, there is a large-scale unanimity across India at the government, state government level, barring the BJP-ruled states, and at every political party level. What you are talking about is differences of detail and nuance. Everybody is one in terms of finding it outrageous. Everybody is one in saying that there should be this and that palliative. Now, we may not be one in maximum two cases in terms of the remedies, but that doesn't detract from the fact, and I'm not talking of the public's anger, your questions are political parties. Every political party has joined in Rajya Sabha, my house, they've joined in Lok Sabha, they've joined in the states. The only two exceptions of which a lot of exaggeration is happening is the JDU and the Odisha ruling party, where also, by the way, their basic stand is with us, but there is, I agree, and that's why I said I'll fractionally and partially concede to you a difference of view. Now, you can't get in a democracy like India. Mm-hmm. The very substance of that democracy is this divergence of view.
Okay.
But for Mr. Modi or his party to think that this means that there is a fractured opposition would be the biggest blunder. There is no greater unanimity in the 2.5 years of this government on a issue across states and across party political line than this one. Tell me a single issue which has united the opposition more. Now, the difference of degree does not detract from the fundamental unity.
Dr. Singhvi, you made your point. You're only partially agreeing with me. But let me then take that to Mahua Mitra of the Trinamool Congress. Because Mahua Mitra, the two images on Kolkata streets were interesting. The left calls for a band. But the Trinamool Congress has its own chief minister marching on the streets as part of a protest march. They don't join hands and do any joint protest. Each one of them is engaged in one-upmanship. Your chief minister doesn't want to be seen with the left. The left doesn't want to be seen with her. I mean, the sense one is getting is clearly no political opposition. The political opposition is simply playing a game of one-upmanship. Whether it's Mamata Banerjee or whether it's the left. The left calls for a band. Mamata says, no, I will do my own independent protest march. So where is the unanimity? In terms of how do you actually want to take on Mr. Narendra Modi's demonetization move?
Rajdeep, I think I'd like to take your question and turn it on its head. Mm-hmm. I think that's a rather unfairly framed question. The first thing is, it is not the onus of it. The onus is not on the opposition to prove its credibility on this issue. The onus is very much on the ruling party and on the government to back and to prove its credibility on an issue that is not backed by law. It is completely not backed by law. That is morally incorrect in its stand, in that it seeks to divide the nation on, if you're with us, you're patriotic, and if you're not, then you're a bunch of unpatriotic, corrupt hate mongers. And the third is one which is based on flawed economic policy. So I think the onus is very much on the ruling government in the day. It has nothing to do with the fact whether the different political parties have different parliamentary strategies and have different ways in protesting what is essentially a united front.
You say it is essentially a united front, but I get the sense that Mamata Banerjee is pitching herself as if she is the leader of this so-called opposition. Why can't, please tell me, do you concede that there are sharp divisions between you and the left?
Rajdeep.
Do you concede that there are sharp divisions between you and the left because y'all are implacable Rajdeep. Enemies? Suddenly you find yourself in a situation where Narendra Modi has become your target number one, but you are unable to come on one platform.
Rajdeep, like I said, I said you're the anchor of the show. You can hypothesize about whether she's projecting herself as a leader or not. I'm the spokesperson for the party, and I'm certainly not going to agree with that. I think we've removed the left after a 34-year regime, and in this issue we are against the BJP, and the left is against the BJP as well. That's what binds us together. But I don't think that the agenda for the Trinamool Congress is going to be laid by the left.
Okay, let me then come for a moment to Atul Anjan, because I just want to come to Sambit Patra last. I want to hear the opposition on this, because that is my big question. Atul Anjan, the left, does it see any commonality with Mamata Banerjee on this issue? For the longest time, you have accused Mamata Banerjee, whether in Sarda or Narda, of actually receiving large amounts of money in cash. Today, on the issue of black money, can you be seen on the same platform as Mamata Banerjee? Do you believe that Mamata Banerjee is someone who can lead this movement against black money?
Rajdeep.
Yes.
Today, let us not discuss all these niceties and the political compulsions and what their strategy and tactics and all that. Mm-hmm. Today is the main question. Throughout, we from the left side has not given a Bharat Band call. Let us be very clear. Mm-hmm. We have said the people of this country will protest, project their protest, they will register their protest in various forms. Take the case in Bihar, in Patna, the people's artists, they with their drums and all that, they were on the street and singing songs. That was also a protest. People were distributing leaflets. That was also a protest.
Mr.
People
Anjana, were I asked FPGs. You a question.
That was also protest.
In Do you believe Mamata Banerjee has the credentials to lead this protest?
No, I'm just.
You believe a Lalu Prasad Yadav has the credentials to lead the protest? You believe that DMK with Kani Modi and Dayanidhi Maran have the locus and the credibility to lead a protest on black money?
No. I am here to protest on the black money, the concept of the government, the way they have brought, you see, standstill to all, you see, trade and all that, the people's hardship. They are in queue. They are already protested. Now the political activists, you said, only political activists. Yes, in a democracy, political activists protest. So I am not going to answer all what was your hypothesis and questions. I am here that there is a broad understanding to register the protest, and that way, our strategy was the CPI, CPM, RSP, Forward Bloc, ML and all that. March separately, strike together. And though everybody was striking against this, the concept of the Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi ji.
Okay.
We were not said the Bharat Band. It is the Pradhan Mantri who said in Kushinagar Bharat Band. He used to make all the things which is not with the reality. He makes many things, you see.
Mr. Anjan,
Bayan Bahaduri,
Mr.
That
Anjan,
is not
just
the
a minute.
Necessity of the time.
Mr. Anjan, you are saying
there was
that
a
this
broad
is a
understanding inside the parliament and outside. There was an understanding.
There was an understanding. Sambit Patra, these images that are playing out since the morning in different parts of the country, political activists belonging to different parties have come out against the government. Do you see this as any kind of threat? Or do you believe this is an advantage to the BJP? Because the BJP, as the Prime Minister has chosen to put it, is saying, do you want black money band or do you want Bharat band? So the Prime Minister has very cleverly played it and really looked at this issue by positioning the opposition as being pro-black money. Do you think that he's being a little unfair, Narendra Modi, in saying that anyone who protests demonetization is pro-black money? Is this the way the debate and dialogue should take place?
Rajdeep, as far as your first question, the initial question is concerned, that if the opposition, which is not divided, which is not united on this issue, which presents itself as a divided house, who is it going to benefit? Mr. Modi or the Bharatiya Janata Party? I would say I would be reducing the debate into small platform if I just think about the Prime Minister or the Bharatiya Janata Party, as would the Prime Minister himself think. In fact, could benefit the country in large. That the opposition today has been exposed in front of the people, as Ms. Moitra was also pointing out, that the onus to prove the credibility lies with the government. And with the Bandh call going flop, with this Akrosh Divas going a flop, and when the opposition is exposed, the largest beneficiary is the country, because the country, the astonishing part is, despite the fact that people were facing inconveniences, are still facing inconveniences, they are standing rock solid behind the Prime Minister, rock solid behind the scheme of demonetization.
You're not answering my question.
Yes.
If I question demonetization, if I protest against it, does that mean I am pro-black money? Is this what the Prime Minister of the country wants everyone to believe? Is this what you believe? That today, if I question demonetization and its benefits and its execution, am I pro-black money?
Not at all. The Prime Minister never said that. Right from the very beginning, let me remind you, on the very first day when the parliament session began,
the Prime Minister said exactly that. The Prime Minister said the choice is between black money bund and Bharat bund. Do you want to be with those who are black money, who want black money bund, or those who want Bharat bund? The Prime Minister's exact words were that in Kushinagar.
I know my Prime Minister's word. I know my Prime Minister's word more than what you have stated over here, Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai. But give me some time. I would conclude as to why the Prime Minister was absolutely right. Mm-hmm. Right from the day one, that is November 16, when the high offices, the minister said that we all are ready for debates and discussion. Well, yes, there are inconveniences. So please go ahead, ask your questions, put up your suggestions. We will take your suggestions. Mm-hmm. If that was the aim of the opposition, to ease out the inconveniences, we were with the opposition, we should have worked together. But the opposition was divided. There were houses in the opposition who were in the morning saying that they were with the demonetization, and by the evening half of the members were saying that please roll back the demonetization. The whole of the opposition is confused, and this confounded confusion of the opposition only points to the fact that somewhere or other the opposition is trying to protect the corrupt. The opposition is trying to protect the ones who are holding the black money. Because if you are concerned about the inconveniences of the people, come and debate on the floor of the parliament. Don't disturb the normal life.
Confusion
is what has exposed the opposition.
Okay, opposition is confused, and you are confused in parliament and outside, Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Let me play you a graphic, Dr. Singhvi, and I want you to respond. Because washouts and scams, Dr. Singhvi, a 2 hours washout, for example, means 3 crores, which is the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha bribery case. 1 day washout is 7 crores, which is the fodder scam of 1990. 2 days washout, 20 crores, HDW submarine scam. 3 days washout, 32 crores, the UTI scam of 2001. 7 days washout, 64 crores, the famous Beaufort scam. 15 days washout becomes the urea scam. The sense that Dr. Singhvi, when I play these figures, is that taxpayers' money is once again being wasted in parliament because the opposition is confused. You have decided that unless Prime Minister Modi is present throughout the debate, there will be no debate. Dr. Manmohan Singh says, I support the objectives of demonetization, but I protest against the way it's being executed. There seems to be confusion.
Rajdeep, 3 or 4 points.
Yes,
sir. The reason I was putting up my hand earlier,
yes,
I just wanted to make a short, quick point before I answer your question, that there is a rather delicious irony in that you started the program by saying a lack of unity.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's really a perception of whether you see the glass one quarter full or three quarters full or one quarter empty. because you, I think we failed to notice that two sworn enemies, never more antithetical poles of political life than the left and the Trinamool in Bengal, have actually talked after decades on an issue like this. Can anybody have more gigantic unity of the opposition than even the very possibility of Mamata Banerjee's party and the left talking to each other for a possible coordination? I think that is what Mr. Modi has achieved. You might be seeing the 25% glass half empty, but not the large amount of it which is full. Now, coming to your question, I think as far as disruption in parliament is concerned, which is not the subject matter of this program, let me tell you that published statistics prove, that the BJP, which has been immediately prior to 2 years ago, 10 years out of power, 10 years, their disruptions of parliamentary sessions have been five times more, I repeat, five times more than disruptions by the present opposition. You are talking about 10 days, 7 days. We've had whole sessions wiped out hardly 2.5, 3 years ago,
sir,
on trivial issues like JPC.
Dr.
I think
Singhvi,
public memory is short.
Dr. Singhvi,
so let's be clear.
Dr.
Let's talk,
Singhvi,
I'm not
the message going
game.
Out.
By and large,
the perception
we have
is
been
that
much
the
opposite.
The perception is yes, the Prime Minister
two,
does not want to sit through
answer.
A debate and take questions, but the perception also is that the opposition does not want to go through
can
a full
I,
debate.
Can I answer now? I was. Let me just answer. I've answered two of your points. The third aspect is that the Prime Minister, the debate did start.
Yes.
The Prime Minister has spoken, he has made this into his biggest initiative of his political life. He has promulgated it, he has spoken to the nation, he has spoken about it 100 times a day everywhere.
Yes.
If Parliament asks him to be around right through the debate to take it seriously, how is it not strange that this Prime Minister is speaking in Japan to Mann Ki Baat? He's speaking on AIR and radio and television, but he doesn't want to speak in Parliament. And it's only now that you're having very reluctantly and belatedly, highly belatedly, this offer that he will reply. The official offer has come today that he will be there to respond.
Can I get Sambit Patra to respond to that? Sambit Patra, please respond to what Dr. Singhvi is saying. Dr. Singhvi is saying that a Prime Minister who can speak in Mann Ki Baat on Sunday, who can go across the country campaigning on demonetization, cannot face opposition questions in the Rajya Sabha. Why?
In Japan.
I'll answer this for a very important issue.
No, please answer this.
Just a second.
I want you to answer this.
Just a second.
Don't divert it.
I would have answered this by now. I'm not diverting it, but Mr. Singhvi, in fact, gave away the whole game. I never expected an erudite lawyer like him to give away the game. He said that what Mr. Modi has achieved with this demonetization is arch rivals like Mamata Banerjee and the left have come together on a common plank. Never before in the history did these two political parties get any opportunity of common benefit for people. They had to come together. Is this the only issue on which they felt that the whole world was falling apart?
No.
Were there not agricultural
Dr. Patra,
debt
please answer my question. Dr. Patra, answer my question. The Prime Minister can do a Mann Ki Baat. He can go across the country talking about demonetization, but he cannot talk about it in Parliament. Why?
Who said that he would not talk in the Parliament?
Why can
in
he
fact,
not sit in a debate?
Leaders,
Both Why can he not sit through a debate?
No.
How is he that busy that he cannot sit through a debate?
Rajdeep, you must not be watching television.
The Prime Minister has not sat through the debate. He refused to sit through the debate.
You have to allow a spokesperson to speak. You are not interrupting Abhishek Manu Singhvi the same
way. I was. Please let. If you go away from the topic, I will interrupt you. Otherwise, I won't. You're not answering me.
I am not. I'm answering you, Rajdeep. Probably you missed those two debates when the Prime Minister, both in Lok Sabha as well as in Rajya Sabha, was sitting through the debate. But yet the opposition, in fact, did not allow the debate to happen. Opposition has been changing its goalposts right from the very beginning. Number three, you know that both Mr. Arun Jaitley, the finance minister on the floor of Rajya Sabha, and today Rajnath Singh, the home minister on the floor of Lok Sabha, categorically mentioned that when the time be, the Prime Minister will intervene in this subject. The irony is the opposition does not even ask the questions and they want the answers.
Okay.
How can the Prime Minister answer to unasked questions? Have you asked the questions? You want the answers to come first without the questions? What kind of opposition is this?
Okay, That's your answer. But Mahua Mitra, it's very interesting. What seems
Raj,
to really...
No,
no, one minute. Mahua Mitra, what seems
Mr.
to be... what
Raji,
seems to be happening, Mahua Mitra and Atul Anjan. I'll come to both of you.
One
minute, Atul Anjan. Mahua Mitra, what seems to be happening is the Prime Minister has pulled the rug under your feet. The fact is that he has actually taken over the political narrative. He's reaching out directly to the people, including the poor, by projecting himself as some kind of a Robin Hood, who's going to rob from the, who's going to take away from the rich and give to the poor. For parties like the Trinamool and the left, that means he's taking away even part of your constituency. You are scared, Mahua Mitra, what the Prime Minister is doing, because this could be his Indira Gandhi moment of 1969, where he builds a new constituency for himself. Are you worried? And that's why you're hitting the street. Mamata Banerjee is betraying nervousness.
Yes, I think Mamata Banerjee definitely needs to take a lesson or two from the 56-inch chest of the Prime Minister and sort of learn the aaj kuch tifani karte hai kind of politics that he seems to be excelling at. Rajdeep, number one. The second thing is, I'd like to come in very quickly on what the BJP spokesperson just said, and I'm surprised you didn't get him on that. He's prevaricating completely on national television, and he said that the Prime Minister sat through the debate. I think all of India saw on Rajya Sabha television. I'll be delighted to pay for a subscription for him if he doesn't have access to RSTV. It's the Prime Minister came in for, I think, an hour and a half on one day and sat through three speeches, that of the Bahujan Samaj Party, of the Trinamool Congress, and I think of the Samaj Party Party. After lunch,
Mahua Mitra, is it not true? Is it not true that regional parties work on cash?
That is completely incorrect.
Regional parties work on cash increasingly, and the Prime Minister has cut your cash. That's why there is desperation. That's why there is this nervousness in parties like Trinamool. Your party works on a cash economy.
Rajdeep, from your questioning, it would seem that the BJP seems to work on a cashless economy and has spent what is the largest advertising spend for any party in the history of Indian politics in the last 5 years. And I'd be very surprised to know if that money came from the planet Mars or Pluto. So let's answer that question first. 80% of their source of funding is unaccounted and is from unknown sources. So let's have state funding on elections. We called for it in 2004 in our manifesto. The Prime Minister, for all his sort of bravado, has not yet come out and said, let's have state funding on elections. So when we have that, let us start countercasting aspersions on different parties. And by the way, we're not a regional party, we're a national party, I'll have you know. Thank you so
much. But on that note to you, Atul Anjan of the left, the question I originally posed, is Narendra Modi a right-wing politician taking the votes of the poor away from you? That's why parties like the left have no answer. He's now reaching out to the poor. Today he's saying he's going to have a Garib Kalyan Yojana. He's going to increase tax penalties for those who are caught with black money, who don't disclose their income. He is doing to you what will perhaps finish your vote bank. He's reaching out to the poor.
Rajdeep, we have heard, we have seen this BJP government earlier also. People were talking too much about when Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji was the Prime Minister. And what we have seen, what shining India, what sort of, you see, problem it has to face and where they collapse. I just want to say one thing. If two parties, two political adversaries party, if they are on a national paramount importance, come together and talk something and act on some issue together, you think it's a very big bad thing. And I just want to know what happened in Jammu Kashmir. Those who were called for 20 years anti-national PDP people, now BJP is joining hand with them, and the PDP is the chief minister.
Let's not divert issues.
Despite all
Atul Anjan,
Atul Anjan, the left more than any other party has stood up against black money.
The left has always spoken out against black money. Today the Prime Minister claims, we don't know the actual benefits, but claims he's going to take on black money holders, he's going to prosecute them, he'll impose higher penalties. Should the left not be with him?
I just want to say, if the Prime Minister is very much interested to participate in the debate, and he will reply back, why he doesn't stand up and says, Madam Speaker, I am here, sitting, hearing the different viewpoint, I will reply back. He could have said it. Why he is not speaking and somebody, some minister is speaking on his behalf? Do you think he is so top that he will not reply, he will not even speak in front of the speaker. What sort of thing this country is facing now?
No, 1 minute. I want to get final comments from all.
Can I answer this?
Yes, Sambit Patra, you are not answering my basic question, that we have a prime minister who likes one-way communication. This is not a prime minister who likes hard questions, which is why in the Rajya Sabha, where he will be asked those hard questions, he doesn't want to face the opposition. That is also a reality. Yes, the opposition is divided. Yes, it is discredited. But the prime minister also doesn't want to face hard questions.
So who said that? I mean, in fact, look, let's not take the people of this country for granted. They understand all these nuances, and that's the reason as to why we have an election result that we have in the local bodies of Maharashtra today. And when the WhatsApp, the Narendra Modi app results were out, 5 lakh people had voted, the same opposition parties were saying, this is not representative voting. What does 5 lakh people mean? Mm-hmm. These are bhakts which are voting. And today, the local body election in Maharashtra, where they're all bhakts who are voting us. Did we win because of the bhakts only? Mm-hmm. Thanks that India is gradually becoming what I would say bhaktified, if that's what they mean to say. Mm-hmm. But the larger point is, the session is not over. The winter session is still on. The Prime Minister would definitely intervene on this issue. The tall ministers have called upon that issue. So please, let the Parliament function. Let seriousness ensue. Mm-hmm. Let the opposition not expose itself any further. Let it be mature and sincere, because this is a fight against the black economy of the country. This is a fight against terror funding. Naturally, they should stand together on this very serious issue. If they have questions,
we are ready to come together. Mr. Sambit Patra, the success of the Prime Minister is that he has convinced the country that demonetization will lead to the end of terror funding. It will lead to the end of black money. There are huge question marks whether that will actually happen, which is why there needs to be a more informed debate rather than this simplified debate, black money band or Bharat band, or anti-national or nationalistic. But to you, Abhishek Manu Singhvi, there is a point in what Sambit Patra said. When there was a WhatsApp poll, you said this is a poll sponsored by the Prime Minister by Bucks. Now in municipal election, the BJP is leading in Maharashtra. In the bi-polls, the BJP did well. Are you conceding at least that the Prime Minister at the moment has the political edge? Because you are discredited. How can a Dayanidhi Maran, who's been involved, who's been accused in a serious scam, a Kani Modi, accused in a serious scam, a Lalu Prasad, accused in a serious scam, a Mamata Banerjee, whose party men have faced charges in Sardar, how can they stand up and claim they are against black money, or the Congress party, which itself presided over the scams between 2009 and 14? That's the problem. He has hit you where it hurts, and he's benefiting.
Rajdeep, your question formulated in response to the BJP's response just now really underscores the fundamental fallacy of this debate as framed by the BJP.
Mm-hmm.
Let me concede that every criminal in this country who is in for black money doesn't have a right to speak, and black money must be exterminated. Let me concede that fake currency must be exterminated. Let me concede that soiled and unusable notes must go out, and let me concede that cashless economy must reign here. Put your hand on your heart, Rajdeep, and ask anybody here, will any of these four possible objectives be achieved by what has been done? The debate is that it's been taken to the first point. You cannot have for 400 crores, which is the Indian Statistical Institute's published study. By the way, ISI had Mahalan Baris, PC Chakravarti, so many people, outstanding statisticians, have published a report officially long time ago. 400 crores is the maximum of fake currency in this country. Please double it arbitrarily. For 1,000 crores, would anybody demonetize 15 lakh crores? The totality of unaccounted black money cash is published reports 6%. Did Mr. Modi know that when he demonetized the currency?
Sir, you may be right with your figures. You may be right with your figures, but the people believe Mr. Modi more than the Congress. The people seem to be believing Mr. Modi more than the opposition.
What is the point you are debating? All that you are saying, Rajdeep, all that you are saying is that the moment I argue on merits on debate, I am a supporter of all the illegalities. That's the old fascist way of looking at things. If you disagree with me, you are anti-national.
Oh,
as somebody put it, if you don't use this khadi, you are anti-national. If you don't use Patanjali shampoo, you are anti-national. That's the point.
Sir, at the end of the debate, the people seem to be at the moment, credibility
but
of the
Mr.
Prime
Singhvi,
Minister
you would
seems
not
higher
need
than
Patanjali shampoo or any shampoo.
The
just
credibility
the
of the opposition
Mr.
Singhvi, is at
just
stake.
Just a parting rhetoric. You would not need
know,
any shampoo, Mr. Singhvi.
But
just
those
rhetoric.
Who...
No, let's leave it there. Let's leave it there now. Let's leave it on that. Who needs shampoo or not, I don't know. But I will tell you one, Mr. Patra, while you smile. Please understand, a friend of mine today was at New Delhi Railway Station. A number of construction workers are migrating back to their villages because construction sites are closing. Please understand that, Mr. Patra. So while you on this program,
we understand that. Yes,
I hope you do. And I hope you empathize with people who are going back to their villages. I hope you empathize with those who are losing their jobs also.
When the disease was huge, naturally there would be some pain, but we would get back.
I see. It's very nice in an AC studio to talk about pain, sir.
Rajdeep,
the seeds and the... And the fertilizers and their
Rajdeep,
ideas sitting on
Rajdeep.
Their land.
Yes, yes, Dr. Singh.
Rajdeep.
No,
yes.
I mean, with this kind of logic, it means that just because...
Two sentences.
Just a second.
Rajdeep, two sentences.
Mr. Singhvi, since a number of questions were raised by you and some questions asked by Rajdeep, just give me 2 seconds and then you can please continue.
Yes.
Just 2 seconds.
Yes.
I mean, with this kind of logic, that just because one act of demonetization would probably not end all the black money, would probably not suffocate all the Naxals, probably not dry up all the terror fund, we should just keep a hand on hand and seated. We should not be doing anything. It's a faulted logic. It is a beginning.
Okay.
It is not the end.
Let's leave
and it is a big beginning.
Okay, it's a big beginning is what the government claims, the opposition claims. It's
Rajdeep,
only...
Rajdeep,
yes.
2 sentences.
Yes, 2 sentences
Rajdeep,
only.
2 sentences.
Yes.
It is not. It
Rajdeep,
is not.
Can we answer,
it
please?
Not.
Somebody.
I'd like to answer
harassment
as well.
Of the
somebody
people.
Mentioned.
The
somebody mentioned.
The countryside is on
Rajdeep,
a standstill.
Somebody mentioned
the poor
shampoo.
Farmers and agriculture
somebody
workers
mentioned
are
shampoo.
Yes.
Rajdeep,
yes, what is your point, Dr. Singhvi? Quickly.
Somebody mentioned shampoo in response to my... Somebody mentioned shampoo in response to
you
my
mentioned
Patanjali
shampoo. You
what
first
has happened
mentioned
is that
shampoo.
The Prime Minister
yes.
has tried to shampoo 87%. Can I just finish, please?
Yes.
The Prime Minister of this country has tried to shampoo 87% of our currency because somebody has sold him a lemon to believe that it will become shining
but
white.
But why are you conditioning
and
the black money?
Really,
let's leave it there.
We are trying to shampoo off the black money.
Let's
why are you
That's it. That's it. I'm afraid we have to leave it there. Once you enter a serious debate on demonetization and it starts ending with what shampoo someone should be using, you know that you're completely drifting away from the central issue. And the central issue is, do you have a divided and discredited opposition at the moment, which means at least the political advantage. Forget about the long-term economic benefits or otherwise off the move. At the moment, the political advantage may well be resting with Narendra Modi. Let's take a break, because coming up next, within 24 hours of his daring escape from Punjab,